And this is why we are using the laser technology. So after you have done the separation, then you see here you're going in that area where you use where we are using laser technology. Mm-hmm. We are using laser technology for the cutting and the welding. Mm-hmm. What means cutting? Cutting means, so before we go into the machine, we have that part.
Yes.
And then we go into the cutting machine and then you get a part like this.
Uh-huh.
So this is now, as you can see, more or less the final half blade. So either way you have the anode blade or the cathode blade, that you really have the final shape, which is then good to use for the next steps.
Mm-hmm. So this gets cut out with lasers?
Yes, basically. Right.
Okay.
And it's very critical. Maybe you see here the very thin small holes here in that area.
Yes, I actually do that.
And this is why we are using the laser technology, because they need to have a very high accuracy.
Yes.
The edge of the holes, they need to be perfect. Mm. Yeah, no burr left or something like this, because this is a very critical area. Also around the areas here, because these are the ports for the hydrogen, the air, the water for cooling, etc. So they need to have a really high edge quality.
So
as you can see here also in the process, sometimes you have designs like this, where you can see it is not even a flat hole, it's really like in 3D shape, and that's very complicated.
How do you do this? You
laser.
So basically you use the hydroforming and then you just cut off that
part. It's formed before and then we used laser, so the laser is really a very flexible process.
And when you laser, when you cut, it just falls off that part, or you need to get it?
The small parts, this is a special process like you can see here.
Yeah.
This is a process where we are using nitrogen in the cutting process, and the nitrogen is responsible for having a very good edge quality, and it blows also the material out. So
wonderful.
Good for the next process step. So the next step, as you can see here, this was now the cutting station.
Yes.
Then we would go into the welding station.
Okay.
Welding station means also you need to have two blades, right?
Because
like to weld something.
Yes.
And this means, for example, you have here now two blades, so the anode and the cathode blade. And what's need to be done, you need to take the two blades and you need to put the two blades, maybe that way, put it together like this. On top of each other.
Yes.
And then you need to do the welding. As you can see here now, it is very critical. So. Without having a special machine, a special clamping, fixing technology, you can't do the welding. And this is a very critical...
So we see the two plates that get to be put together.
Right.
Where do they get welded? At the edges or...?
Really, this is defined by the customer. Mm-hmm. So every bipolar blade has a weld seam around the blade and around the ports because they need to be leak tight. Some customers, they have also stitch welds here in the flow field to have a better contact resistance, to have it more stable. But this is really depending on the customer, how they make their design.
Okay, understood. Understood.
So, and if we then have a look for the process for the welding, we need to look where we are.
Get that back and then... there we are.
One more. Right.
Yeah.
So, and this is what I tried to explain. You see here the small gap between the blade, and this needs to be as small as possible.
Oh, understood.
Because what you do with the laser will melt up this area here and bring the two materials together.
Okay.
And so this is why the laser welding process is the most critical process in the production line. It is not only about that you know how you need to adjust the laser, so how much power you need to use for the laser. It's really a big part of the knowledge how you will do the fixation, how you will do the clamping, that you have a really good, more or less the duration for the welding process itself.
Okay.
And also the quality of the forming is also very important for the process, that you get a stable welding process.
Okay.